Guys, Pax Rubiana back again here. This is my goodbye video from this beautiful town of Tirana. I miss it so much. I was not here since the summer. It's really beautiful. And here you see the new highway flyover. This is the city ring road, motorway style, with four lanes. And it's really actually a big infrastructure achievement. In the past, this Lana River exit, because that's the Lana River exit, was always a big hurdle for traffic. And now, this modern new highway, it's still a traffic, is still very dense because it's a big metropolis. But this was a really very good idea to have this city ring road, and it makes it very efficient. And this is something all cities need, actually, Vienna as well. But we have, unfortunately, infrastructure minister from Green, quite extremist anti-highway faction. But here you see this is working. And it was now here you see this area of Kashar, and that's the suburbs, but also there is a lot of investment and a lot of improvement has been done. Here obviously the road is still under construction. That's the highway, the ring road, let's call it, let's not exaggerate it, out of the city and towards the western exit. The problem still of Tirana in the city is basically that the exit is very much limited, and the entry obviously as well. The Cavaia exit here, the Combinat road as it's called, is not finished, and it should be a big secondary road towards the west that's missing. And here obviously you have the one exit towards the airport road. And then the boulevard is also not opened still, and these are all projects which we are talking now since 20 years. And since that, some progress obviously has happened here. This looks very nice now. And this underground pathway, very good. And Tirana needs, in this strategic kind of a valley in which it's situated, it has the southern entry. I showed you this one. And this is one guy who is wanting to jump the highway. He was not a suicide guy, but he was somebody crossing the highway because they didn't foresee. Here is another person, and they wait, and then they run over the highway. This is not exactly the way Europeans should cross highways, and it's not exactly the way European authorities should build highways, because there should be obviously some level of pedestrian crossing. Here we come to this new fantastic infrastructure at the entry point. I've already told the Elbasan entry, I've showed you in the beginning. And then the Combinat entry, which is not finished, not ready, not even started. And this is the main entry to the west, which is also very important. It's the highway to Durres, it's the highway to the airport, it's the highway to Montenegro. Because the northern exit is still under construction, there is one, but it should be a real kind of similar like this one. And the systematic city planning is now getting better. Arion is working, but it's of course far from how it should be. But this is now quite impressive. I drive the first time here. Looks very good. That what was traditionally was called the so-called whatever, Dogana. That's the customs exit. It looks much better now. It's really very good. This was very smooth. It was always costing you 20 minutes when you're unlucky. And that was because the city exit from Durres, from the main road, goes like this. Sogo EC, Dogana, and here Casa Italia. This was also a big effort. Some years ago, I remember I was here in traffic jams up to 3-4 hours in during the construction times. But now it's really smooth. Here you see one of the big hospitals. I had my health crisis this summer. I was in the Spital American, but this is another one which is also very good. The Higea, it's a Greek Albanian group. And here you see, that is obviously the other exit road towards Kamsa, towards the north. And here basically the road to Montenegro. Then you see Macedonia in the back and in the east. And here this is the road to Durres. But the way it's organized, you have basically to use this is the only western exit today still, and that's also the northern exit ultimately, because the rest is much too small. So how it works now is the road towards the highway to the airport and to Montenegro and to the coastal highway and to all infrastructure, it's all this. So basically this is the one bottleneck which they have here, and this highway should have been already with three lanes, obviously, and also with this shopping centers and the commercial center. It's the main direction here, and it's actually quite dramatic. Yeah? So this is not quite smooth driving now, because it's December. A lot of people, when it's raining, are not going out. I love it still when it's raining. Whenever, I don't like when I get a lot of water on my head, but it's nevertheless, it's then the moment the rain is gone, it's again this 15 to 18 degrees, sunny temperature. It's amazing. Here I want to show you all this commercial development, because Albanians are very entrepreneurial, and you see all this amazing new commercial infrastructures with the automotive industry, mainly the construction material, technical industries, and light machinery construction. There's a lot of them, and they are really very successful. That's a meat industry here. That's a big shopping center. So Albania is commercially, and that's a university here for architecture. It has a partnership with the Austrian Technical University. And here you see this big shopping center, JTU. It's one of the biggest ones of one of the most important businessmen of this country, also with Austrian links, Mr. Samir Mane. He started by bringing electronics, used electronics, to Albania with his brothers and family in 30 years ago. And he is now a billion euro rich businessman in industry, in mining, banking, telecoms, and also in tourism, property development, retail, and many other big shopping centers. He is really very big, very serious, and very top level businessman, also with European level of development in corporate governance, and not maybe all aspects, and for Albania is one of the most serious, not that. Here you have private universities, private schools, and more of these construction industry outlets. And also, that's normally all either textile or construction industry, and a little bit of, you know, generators, technical installation, automotive, tourism, and you see quite a lot of them, and that's quite impressive. I will guide you here until the airport, and then see some of these developments in the future. It's just a small ride. Here is also one of the hills. That's basically the hills towards Durres. The DIY Tirana was made the capital is to be protected from the foreign powers, because Durres was the capital in 1912-13 during the war and afterwards. But then the leader of Albania during this, who was backed by Yugoslavia basically, or Serbia, Esad Pasha, he was a landowner here, and he wanted to be less open, how can I say, less exposed towards the British and Italian navies. So Durres was basically downgraded, and he was the landowner here, and he decided to put the capital of Tirana here. It will be the European Youth Capital next year, and it's very important honor for Albania and for Tirana, and I hope that it will be somehow the crystallizing point for adopting the euro and also joining the European Union then 2024. Because even when old people criticize me that this is unrealistic, I insist it's absolutely possible, and it absolutely must be done. This is one of the stranded investments, which there are also many. 40 million euros was invested in a hotel in a kind of palatial style development, very luxurious in inside and outside, but still to this moment not ready, and somehow waiting for better times. And this is of course when they do things without international advice, they often invest a lot of money and then it's not working. That's Megatech, that's one of the construction material outlets here, and also one Italian market I see is coming, Mercato. And this is now the exit towards the highway road, which was part of the concessionary deal with the highway concessionary, which in the meantime is in Chinese hands, to my best knowledge. It was with Chinese founders taking over. It was a German investment. The geography you can see very well now here. It's the mountains on the east towards eastern Albania and Macedonia. I crossed here. On the south you see the road to Elbasan, and it's very rainy. And this basically field of Tirana between mountains on all sides, in the south Elbasan, in the west the mountains towards eastern Albania. In the north it has this road exit open towards Shkodra, and then in the west also the mountain hills which are protecting it from tourists. And then afterwards there is the swamps where also the tragic earthquakes were, and it's quite slummy there actually. Then tourists, obviously I've showed you a lot, it's a lot. And it's also my point that after the earthquake these slums, they should not have been rebuilt, but the people basically gotten vouchers for relocation, because it's very poor and tragic areas. And even when we build now new buildings from the EU and from the government, it will be very, very problematic, because the investment will be stranded. There's really a very poor neighborhood. I feel sorry for the people, but it would have been, there's a road accident here. Yeah, it's a tragedy. They're driving too fast, and then you have this kind of very often. I was working very much on road traffic safety, but it was not possible. And some progress was happening, but they have, especially this airport road is one of the most traffic prone roads. And there is so many accidents of the speed. And the problem is, it's not only the access to the airport, because that would be logical, but it's also the northern exit of the town. And if they would have done some decent highway out exit in the north, then it would be only half of the traffic, because people like us, we're going now to Montenegro, but we have to use the airport traffic road, because there is not really any kind of decent alternative. Otherwise you have to cross the whole city on the northern Kamsa road, and then you're driving basically 20 permanently for 45 minutes. So it's really problematic, the many wrong decisions they have made in the last 20 years. I just wonder, the quality of decision making in Albania over the last years is probably... Also, when you look at the boulevard, what they have done, they have this wonderful location. Then the central bank bought the Hotel Tahiti, and the way to do it was obviously, here's a lot of rich people with good cars. And so you see, the problem is that the decision making is so bad. And instead of building 5-star hotels at the boulevards, they build now again state institutions. And you know, you wonder really what is the reason. This is very interesting. I want to show you first the airport, because it's very modern and very beautiful airport, very successful. And then you see also this Lindner business group, the big business park from this Bavarian investors. They have beautifully invested in the most amazing kind of commercial real estate in the town. It will come now very soon. On the right, it was also Mrs. Merkel was opening that one some years ago. It is quite impressive. First you come to this Turkish university, Epoca. They were accused to be close to this Gulen movement. And then there was a big Albanian-Turkish row about some of the supposed Gulen guys. Yeah, that's of course a very sad tragedy, this 2016 plus development of Erdogan. It's very unfortunate. Here you see a lot of amazing vegetation. It's very fertile plains here, this Tirana plains towards Shkodra they go, and they are very beautifully, but the level of investment in agriculture, it needs to be massively supported. Here's the university I was talking, Epoca University. I was making a speech there in 2013. It was a very nice invitation, thanks a lot. And then you have Lindner Business Park over there. It's this very rich family from Bavaria. They have one in Sofia as well. And here they have also invested significantly, very big, in this very big commercial outlet. Here you can see it. It's, to my knowledge, the best and most important German investment, for sure, the German private sector investment. This is the university, a lot of people here now. And then you see this big, big, ever-expanding business park. They also have a residential development now, and another tower is coming up. It's called Tirana Business Park. That's the brand. And it's quite impressive. Good, I'm talking too much, it seems to be. So more to come. I will just want to guide you through this airport center still. And then you see, oh, it's very beautiful. Look, this is a new one. It's a hotel. Very close to the airport. Makes a lot of sense as well. And then you see more development. Now we're coming directly in the airport zone. We have a lot of traffic. Very good. No, Tirana was now amazing 3 days. It was a good decision to come. I really enjoyed it, meeting a lot of friends, hearing about what's going on. And there's major infrastructure initiatives now coming up that will be really transformative. And you can really feel that the Miss Decade is now over, and there is a lot of international support for European Albania back again. And so after basically Rama could do what he wanted for the last 8 years, and he has performed very badly, now there is a lot of international effort, supervision, and there is crisis management, and there is significant clarity support for European Albania. So I say again, it's time for the Euro, it's time for the EU membership. All the things can be done inside much easier, and as we have seen, this lost decade must be now terminated, closed, and we should always regret it. This is the direct airport zone. It was this concessionary project, first of the American Albanian Development Fund, very successfully, and then they have together, I think it was Hochtief Airport Concessions, they worked on it. Here, this is Castrati, the biggest businessman in town. And here is this beautiful hotel. It seems to be branded now even. And here, COVID testing. And here, obviously, and this is the area towards the airport. And then we are saying goodbye to the airport, because I'm not flying back. I'm going to Montenegro now. And that will be very good here. Excellent. And on the left. And that's the problem, that everybody who wants to go to Montenegro from Tirana basically blocks the airport road. We never wanted to go to the airport. It's called Mother Teresa here. Mother Teresa, you see, very beautiful. That's the VIP entry with a German flag they have here. So, and here German hospital, COVID testing obviously everywhere. And here we are going onwards and upwards towards the north and towards Montenegro. And I will show you Fuschgruja, as I showed in the summer. And we also have here this airport facilities and more to come from Pax Europiana. I will keep you posted. Thanks for watching. And I will also keep you posted about various aspects of road safety, driving to the north, what's the road to do, and more to come. Thanks a lot. Bye.